Hello, Earth citizens. In this video, I will show you a 10-minute routine to activate your first chakra. If you are not familiar with chakras, they are energy centers located from the base of your tailbone, up your spine to the top of your head. We have a total of 7 chakras. Each of those chakras has a different color, a different characteristic, and depending on if you have too much energy or too little energy in any chakra, or if you have some blockage and stagnant energy there, it can affect your mood, your physical health, your mental, emotional state of being, and some personality traits that you can display. So actually, when you understand the chakras and you're able to move any stagnant energy there, you'll be able to create an environment of health physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually inside of your body. In brain education, we say that the first chakra has a deep crimson-red color like this. So today in this video, I want to help you activate and move energy along your first chakra. First of all, your first chakra is located in a very specific point. It's called the perineum. This point is the space in between your anus and your sexual organ. So if you imagine your anus here, your sexual organ here, it's the point right in the middle. So if you sit down on the floor like this, you can kind of feel it. Feel your tailbone and feel your sexual organ, and then move back and forth until you find the center point of those two spaces. And then once you found the center point, sit at that point on the floor and stack your spine above that point. So this is the area of the first chakra. People with healthy energy in their first chakra have a drive for life. Because it's the first chakra, it's the foundation that all the other chakras build upon. So having a strong foundation, like when you have a building, is very important for keeping the integrity of the building, keeping the integrity of your body. So somebody who has good energy in their first chakra has a drive for life. They have a lot of vital energy, a lot of power, a lot of passion, a lot of motivation to live and motivation to get started on things. On the other hand, somebody with low energy in their first chakra or stagnant energy, heavy energy in their first chakra, they have a lower drive for life. So lack of willpower, lack of motivation, lack of passion, apathy, and if that gets really bad, even suicidal thoughts. So in a nutshell, you can kind of see it as if it's healthy, you have a healthy drive for life. Someone who is unhealthy in their first chakra has a low will and drive for life. So check to see where in that spectrum you feel like you fall. And wherever you feel that you fall on that spectrum, that's okay. No judgment. In this exercise, we're going to learn how to activate some energy there. Okay, all right, so first sit with your spine straight, and remember this little exercise that we did in the beginning, moving forward and back from your genitals to your anus, and then finding that middle point. It's kind of around your tailbone area. So I'm gonna give you a few seconds to find that point. Okay, and when you found it, stack your spine on top of that point. Have you found it? When you stack your spine, you can kind of feel like you're growing taller, a little bit more straight and aligned. All right, and just a little tip, if you practice meditation and you practice sitting down like this, this is always the first step you should take to correctly straighten your energy along your chakras. Okay, and then now bring your palms together in front of your chest. Close your eyes, take a few breaths into your abdomen or as deeply as you can, and then exhale out. One more. Last one, deep breath in. Imagine you're breathing now all the way down to your tailbone. Okay, stop, open your eyes, keep your hands together in front of your chest. Now we're going to lift and drop. So use your thigh muscles and butt to lift and then drop. When you drop, I really want you to drop, not lift and come down, not like this, okay? You should wiggle when you drop like this. Lift, drop, lift, drop, like that. The dropping movement will tap and open up blockages in your first chakra area, okay? Let's do 30 times. Are you ready? 1, 2. If you're not wiggling, you're not dropping enough. 3, let gravity drop. 4, 5, 6, 7. Feel your tailbone. Can you feel the vibration? 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Feel your tailbone. 20. And as you do this, the vibration will help you open up any of the blockages there. 1, 2, 3, 4. You might feel some soreness. 5, that's blockages coming up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Great job. Stop. Close your eyes. Feel your tailbone. Do you feel some subtle tingling sensation? Maybe some subtle warmth? Feel that energy. That's energy opening. Blockages opening in your tailbone. 3 breaths deep into your tailbone. 1 more time. Breathe in. Imagine you're breathing from your tailbone. Exhale. Again, breathe in. Exhale. Last one, breathe in. Exhale. Okay, great. Now relax your hands on your knees. And now, pivoting around your tailbone, I want you to make circles. So when you pivot around your tailbone, when you lean to the left, your right butt cheek goes up. When you lean to the right, your left butt cheek goes up. So imagine your body is like a top and you're rotating around your tailbone. Let's do 10 times one way, 10 times the other way. 1, really push against your tailbone. 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now the other direction. 1, can you feel your tailbone? 2, breathe. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, stop. Now bring the bottoms of your feet together. Butterfly. Open your groin a little bit. Opening your groin will also help you open your first chakra. 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop. From here, breathe in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Ha. Stay here, breathe in. Exhale, ha. One more time, breathe in. As you exhale, gently roll up. Ha. Great job. Release your legs. Bring them back into half lotus posture. And one more time, feel that point between your anus and your sexual organ. And stay there. Stack your spine up. Relax your hands on your knees. Close your eyes. As your eyes are closed, carefully feel your pelvic floor, especially around your tailbone. Can you feel some subtle tingling, electric sensation, maybe some warmth, or even some coldness? All of these signs are evidence that energy is moving and circulating in that area. Great job. Now open your eyes. For some of you, you may still not feel much down here. That's okay. If you don't feel the tingling or the warmth or the coldness that I'm describing, it just means that it needs more work to really open up and break up what's stagnant in there. And then you'll be able to feel some energy senses as soon as you open this up a little bit more. So please feel free to go do this routine again. Honestly, as many times as you can, doing this will help you open that area. You did a great job. To experience a full 1 hour brain education based class, please visit a local body and brain yoga studio near you.